Hey, welcome to Cubs Classics. I'm Cole Wright. Now, over the next few hours, we're going to relive one of the most memorable games in this storied franchise's history. And this one, it's going to take us back to opening day 1994. All of the passion, all of the emotion, it's going to rush right back, and we're going to experience it right here together. Now, even though he had 30 home runs in the minor leagues in 1993, Carl Tuffy Rhodes was regarded more for his speed than his power when he made the Cubs opening day roster in 1994. Now, it was that speed that slotted Rhodes in the leadoff spot for the opener against Dwight Gooden and the New York Metropolitans. Now, the wind, it was gusty, blowing out to left at 22 miles per hour that day, but no one, absolutely no one, saw a historic performance coming from Rhodes, especially since he had just 5 career home runs at the major league level and was facing the Mets' best pitcher and former Cy Young Award winner. Time now to head out to Wrigley Field for a little history from opening day.
Number 23, Ryne Sandberg. Batting third at first base, number 17, Mark Grace. In the cleanup spot, batting fourth, left fielder, number 27, Derek May. Batting fifth in right field, number 21, Sammy Sosa. Catching and batting sixth, number 2, Rick Wilkins. Hitting seventh at third base, number 24, Steve Buschel. Starting at shortstop and hitting eighth, number 12, Sean Dunson. Batting ninth. And pitching this afternoon for our Chicago Cubs, warming up down the left field bullpen, right-hander number 36, Mike Morgan. Ladies and gentlemen, we now direct your attention to the area in front of the Mets dugout. Presenting the colors for today's opening day ceremony is the Glenview Naval Air Station Color Guard. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to honor America, we ask that you all please rise and join along with me, Chicago Cubs public address announcer Wayne Messmer, along with Kathleen Messmer, in the singing of our national anthem, signed today by Kathy Larson.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
It is a very exciting day around the ballpark. To throw out the first ceremonial pitch is Olympic hero Bonnie Blair. Multi-gold award winning winners, and Bonnie Blair will throw out the first ball. She's there with Mr. Cub, Ernie Banks. Quite a thrill for both of them, I assume, as they go out to the mound.
As well as into America's hearts. She began skating at age 2 and 28 years later holds the women's world record in speed skating for the 500 meters. She's won consecutive gold medals in the last three Winter Olympics. Her greatest achievement came at this year's Winter Olympics in Lillehammer, Norway, when she won her fifth Olympic gold medal. Making her most decorated American female Olympian in history, let's give a warm Wrigley Field welcome to one of America's greatest athletes, a Thru Cub fan, escorted by Mr. Cub Ernie Banks. Welcome, Bonnie Blair.
Last weekend, so I'm glad I was able to be here for opening day, and I wish all the Cubs the best this season. I hope maybe I can bring them a little bit of luck, and I wish them all the best. Thank you all very much for your support.
Well, that's what you call equal time, the Republican governor and the Democratic first lady, Hillary Rodham Clinton, talking to Governor Eggert. She'll be out to throw the first pitch in a moment. She's certainly dressed for the occasion with her bright blue, Cub blue hat, or cap. And she's about to be introduced. There's Charlie Brumbach of the Tribune, next to the left of Governor Eggert. And Hillary get a kind of a mixed reception. But being in politics, they both know all about this. She's talking to people around her. You know, she's a native Chicagoan. Yeah, she looks pretty good, doesn't she? She's going to throw the first ball, apparently, from the stands. And she's not going to go on the field. Boy, what a day the weatherman's afforded us. A perfect day. The sun even shined. Here she is being introduced. Now let's watch her throw the ball. All right, not a bad heave. And stay tuned now for baseball coming up in a moment.
Marquee Sports Network presents Cubs Classics. Sammy Sosa hits home run numbers 61 and 62 from the extraordinary 1998 season.
Swung and belted, number 61, move over Bears. Swung and there she goes, number 62.
Catch Slammin' Sammy swinging to history with memories and analysis from the experts. Cubs Classics premieres Monday at 7 on Marquee Sports Network.
We are T-Mobile, the first to go unlimited. First with no annual service contracts. First with taxes and fees included. Now T-Mobile has the first and only nationwide 5G network, reaching over 5,000 cities and towns and over 200 million Americans. And T-Mobile is not charging extra for 5G access. Because this isn't our network, it's yours.
This is the Frells family's land. When the first snow fell, the kids went sledding right there. This used to be a shed. Now, it's where they get breakfast. This is more than just land. It's home. The Frells family runs with us on a John Deere 1 Series tractor. This land isn't the only thing that should live on for generations. Nothing runs like a deer. Search John Deere 1 Series for more. Get a 1 Series tractor starting at $99 per month.
Invites you to move up in the world at the Cadillac Move Up sales event. Move up to available Wi-Fi hotspot capability. Move up to cutting-edge design. Move up to something a little more, well, Cadillac. Make your way to your nearest Cadillac showroom today. During the Move Up sales event, get this low-mileage lease on this 2020 Cadillac XT5 for around $419 per month.
We've always had villains to face.
Bad guys to take down. But you?
You're worse than all of them put together. You are the most horrible of all.
Pure evil.
But just because you're tough
Doesn't mean we can't beat you.
We're not here because we have to be. We're here because we've had enough of you.
Every single one of us is mortal.
Even me. But inside of us, we're all heroes. One person is not a team.
But when we join together...
Together. You don't stand a chance.
We are glorious. We are resilient.
And we will win.
So stand up with us.
Stand up to fight.
To stand up to cancer. Visit standuptocancer.org to learn more.
Hello again, everybody. Harry Carey, Steve Stone, and Tom Brenneman. Here are the lineups for the Mets. Vizcaino, former Chicago Cub, leading off. There's Dallas Green, too, the Mets manager. Todd Hundley, the catcher. Kevin McReynolds in left field. Bobby Bonilla at third base. Jeff Kent, the second baseman. Dave Segui at first base. Jeremy Burdett in right field. Ryan Thompson in center field. And Dwight Gooden, who's beaten the Cubs 26 times during his career while losing to them only four times. Now that Pepsi presents a Cubs defense of Derek May in left, Rhodes, Tuffy Rhodes in center, Sammy Sosa in right, Bouchel, Dunston, Sandberg, and Grace around the infield, Mike Morgan pitching, and Rick Wilkins catching. And with us in the booth, boy, I knew with the first lady of the nation on hand that Irv Cupson would be here too. I know you got a mouthful of hot dog. Go ahead.
Harry, I just came up to wish you 50 more years.
I want to wish you 50 more hot dogs at the same time.
You and I have grown up together, 50 years each. I got you beat by 1 year, 51. But it's a joy to see you working so well, and we have the same attitude. I hope to be found terminal over my terminal. And I know you want to be found the same way in the broadcasting booth.
Thank you very much, Governor.
Fine.
Thank you very much. Irv Cupson, the first pitch. And the count now, 2-0 on Jose Vizcaino, former star infielder of the Cubs. Ball three. And Mike Morgan, who's had a little trouble in spring training, away to a rocky start. Three balls, no strikes on Jose Vizcaino, 26-year-old infielder. There's a strike.
You had a look at last year when Morgan went 10-15, an ERA of 4.03. He did pick up 207 innings. And there's his career against the Mets, a high ERA, 4.42.
Ball four, and he walks the first man he faces. And that, for Mike Morgan, is very uncharacteristic. He usually walks very few. There is Tom Treblehorn, the new manager of the Cubs, going into his first season. He successfully managed at Milwaukee for a few years. And here's Dallas Green, the manager of the Mets. And Dallas did just an outstanding job as a general manager for the Cubs about 10 years ago.
Now, the reason why Hundley's hitting second is the fact that he can move along the runner. So let's see if Dallas Green decides to run early. Todd Hundley actually lost the spot to Kelly Stinnett in spring training, and a lot of people are surprised that Todd Hundley is starting today.
Well, how can they not start him? He's hit a ton against the Cubs. He had only 11 home runs last year against everybody, hit 4 or 5 against the Cubs. There's a strike call. So Todd Hundley, who hit 228 last year, 11 homers, 53 RBI. His dad is Randy Hundley, who caught for the Cubs and was one of the stars of that 69 ball club. Hey, good breaking ball over the inside corner. And Todd Hundley didn't like that. Rick Wilkins looking towards the dugout. I wonder if they're calling any pitches for him, Steve.
Well, I think, Harry, what they might be doing is perhaps calling a pitch out. But here from our new Sky camera, you'll see the last pitch over the inside corner. Jim Quick points it out. And Todd Hundley in a hole 0-2. And you see Wilkins looking again at the dugout. I know they call the pitch outs from there, and Harry, probably an occasional pitch.
0-2 the count. This guy, you know, back. Yeah, I don't know. This ought to be a great year. We don't only have the sky-high camera, we got new microphones.
I know, this is
and hard, new equipment.
Hard to believe.
0-2 the count. Fastball high and inside. Arnie says every 50 years we get new equipment. No, it's got to be less than that, Arnie. Technology moves along so quickly in our business. One ball, two strikes. Whoa! He struck him out. Todd Hundley called out on strike, and he was bewildered by that pitch. Let's see if we can see it again.
From the rooftop camera, you'll see a tailing fastball. It comes back over the middle of the plate. Hundley thought the ball was inside, but that one not only caught the corner, it caught the whole plate, and Jim Quick rung him up.
And so Mike Morgan has fanned one and walked one, and here's Kevin McReynolds, who hit 245 for Kansas City's Royal. One strike and nothing. Mark Grace came off the bag, and so did this Caino on the pitch.
McReynolds is one of 13 new Mets players. 13 different faces in this opening day as opposed to last opening day against the Rockies. So there's a massive changeover on this club.
Yeah, but this guy's not really a new face. He was with the Mets during the Palmy days. It became very terrible days, and they traded him away a few years ago. Now he's back with them. McReynolds, ground ball, base hit in the left field, and the Mets threaten. Runners at first and second, and here is Bobby Bonilla, who hits a ton in this ballpark. Want to wish the old pitcher Cy Johnson, 87 years old, a quick recovery, living in Sheridan now. Last man to strike out Babe Ruth three times. An old-time pitcher. Played with the Reds, the Phillies, the Cardinals, the Boston. A lot of people gone from last year's ball club, and there are some of them. Vince Coleman, now with Kansas City. He probably never light up another firecracker in his life. Here's the pitch a little bit low and outside. Bobby Bonilla. Runners at first and second, one away.
An otherwise dismal Mets year last year, Bonilla still hit 34 home runs, drove in 87. So he filled his part of the bargain.
You know, that surprised me. I thought he hit 34 against the Cubs alone last year.
It seemed like it. It seemed like most of them were in this park, Harry. And especially from the left side, where he's a lot more dangerous.
Yes, and he also hit him right-handed, too. I well recall. This is his favorite ballpark.
Wind is blowing out today.
Ooh, did he have a home run cut? But he fouls it. Two balls and the strike. Mike Morgan, the number one pitcher of the Cubs.
Bonilla did have a pretty good spring. He only hit one home run, but he did hit 366. The Mets as a team had a few guys who hit the ball well, but like the Cubs, they've got some pitching problems, especially in the number 4 and 5 spot in the rotation.
Two balls and the strike. He pulls it foul, and the count evens up 2-2. Texas opening up at Yankee Stadium. Yankees out in front 1-0 at the end of one. Detroit at Boston, no score at the end of one. Seattle at Cleveland leading 1-0 at the end of two. The president threw out the first ball in Cleveland, and the first lady is here in Chicago doing the same thing. They struck him out. A change of pace, and that really fooled Bobby Bonilla. Second strikeout for Morgan.
Take another look at it. Morgan throws the off-speed curveball and has Bonilla way out in front of this one. Good stop by Rick Wilkins. From the sky camera on the roof, you'll see the foot out in front, the hands go forward, and the ball doesn't get there. And that's a big out.
Well, I guess he just gave a classic example how you should pitch to Bobby Bonilla, who has worn out the Cubs previously. Here's Jeff Kent. He hit 21 homers last year. Fouls the first pitch. He hit 270. He was acquired in a trade, and he's become their regular second baseman.
That was the trade that was with Toronto, Harry. Jeff Kent and Ryan Thompson came at the end of the year, and they traded David Cone away. Now, Cone's with Kansas City. Toronto has a ton of talent in their organization, and that's how they get their late-season deals.
0-1 the count. There's no doubt they really do make very telling late season deals. A pitch swung and fouled it off. 0-2. He's had good cuts. Seattle now leads in Cleveland 2-0 at the end of three.
The strides that Jeff Kent made last year were defensive. They thought he could hit. They felt he could hit when he came from Toronto. But he came as a liability at second base. And the second half of last year, he really tightened it up.
0-2 the count. The Yankees now lead Texas 3-0 at the end of three. Bouncing ball, foul down the third baseline. 0-2 the count. Kent, the big kid.
Well, when you talk about big guys in baseball, just about the biggest is standing in the first base coach's box. And that's a man that you're very familiar with, Harry. Frank, yeah. Howard. You saw him take many a cut in the big leagues.
And what a wonderful man he is. Just say, a sweetheart of a guy. 0-2 the count. A little bit low and outside. One ball, two strikes. And I tell you, Rick Wilkins really working out there, going to his knees a lot. Morgan trying to keep the ball down. The wind blowing out. Beautiful day for baseball. That evens it up 2-2. Top of the first. Two on, two out. No score. Jeff Kent. They're playing in the shade towards left. That ought to be an easy third out. Over to first to retire the side. Sandberg throws out Jeff Kent. One hit, no runs, two men left, no errors. We go in the bottom of the first, no score.
Yeah, I'm married. Doesn't matter. You do that for me? Really? Yeah, I'd like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's Jake from State Farm. Sounds like a really good deal.
Jake from State Farm at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's Jake from State Farm.
What are you wearing, Jake from State Farm?
Khakis? Hey, do they ever ask you what you're wearing?
Yeah.
Red sweater, button-down shirt. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You might take something for your heart, your joints, or your digestion. So why wouldn't you take something for the most important part of you, your brain? With an ingredient originally discovered in jellyfish, Prevagen has been shown in clinical trials to improve short-term memory. Prevagen, healthier brain, better life.
This new Samsung Galaxy on Verizon's 5G network is a big upgrade.
This is Ultra, the new Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra 5G powered by Verizon 5G Ultra Wideband.
5G Ultra Wideband is so much faster than even my home internet.
With ultra-fast speeds.
In the gaming world, if you lag, you're done. With Verizon 5G Ultra Wideband, I don't worry about lag.
Now, buy one of our newest Samsung Galaxy 5G phones and get an S20 Plus on us.
You can download a movie that normally takes 20 minutes in like 20 seconds.
There's 5G, then there's Verizon 5G.
Get to know where to place your next bet on Follow the Money on Marquee Sports Network. Vegas veterans Mitch Ross and Paulie Howard host this hour-long show, share their knowledge of sports and gambling.
The Cubs always take money, so it doesn't matter. Everyone would come to town and bet the Cubs win the World Series, no matter who was on the team.
Get the most up-to-date information in live odds, predictions, and betting trends from the sports gambling capital of the world. Follow the money, weekdays at noon, on Marquee Sports Network.
When America's service members move forward, they're unstoppable. Unstoppable in their mission. Since 2003, Wounded Warrior Project has advocated for these heroes. Our mission is helping injured veterans achieve their highest ambition with free services in mental health, career counseling, and long-term rehabilitative care. And warriors never pay a penny for our programs. They're unstoppable heroes. Support warriors today at woundedwarriorproject.org.
Harry Carey back at Wrigley Field. There is Pepsi presenting the Cubs lineup. There you see the manager, Tom Treblehorn. Rhodes in center field. Sandberg at second base. Grace at first base. May in left field. Sosa in right. Wilkins catching. Bouchel at third. Dunston the shortstop. And Morgan the pitcher. And there's the Pepsi Cubs lineup. The New York defense, McReynolds in left. Thompson in center. Burnett's in right. Bonilla at third. Vizcaino at short. Kent at second. Segui at first. Doc Gooden on the mound. And Todd Henley is the catcher. The umpires are Jim Quick behind the plate, Bob Davidson in first, Gary Davis in second, and Bill Hahn in third. That evens it up, a ball and a strike. Now, Tuffy Rhodes has been an outstanding player ever since he joined the Cubs last fall. Curveball a little high. Two balls and the strike. Gooden has an almost unbelievable record against Chicago teams, against the Chicago Cubs. Ball three. 26 victories, only four defeats, and I think he's 12-1 at Wrigley Field. Unbelievable. Swings. Fouls it off.
Well, the Cubs managed to beat him twice in his inaugural season of 1984. That's when he was 19 years old. They roughed him up the first time, getting him for 6 runs. Second time, they got him for 5 runs. Then he pitched a gem against him in September. But after that first year, Dwight Gooden has been close to untouchable. And it seems like, doesn't matter what the Cubs score against him, he'll beat him 10-8 if he has to.
3-2 pitch. Swung on. High fly ball. Way back. Might be. Could be. Center field corner of the left field bleacher. Listen to the crowd.
Well, Harry, he took a 3-2 curveball and hit it out of the ballpark and almost hit it completely out of the ballpark. Well, he doesn't know that Dwight Gooden has been that good against the Cubs. He just took a 3-2 pitch and hit it out of the park.
So the Cubs already on the board. Here's Sandberg. Curveball a little bit low. Inside. Boy, that's a happy dugout, and you know that's a happy, happy Tuffy. And you know the nickname Tuffy is given him by his mother. And that's why he likes to be called Tuffy. And he always likes to be remembered to his family. There he is. A looper. Sharp right field on the run, base hit. Sandberg loops a single to right. And here is Mark Grace.
Well, that's two curveballs and two base hits, and Gooden is not used to seeing his curveball get hit like that. Although Sandberg didn't hit it particularly hard, he hit it in a great spot. Jeff Kent couldn't get to it, neither could Jeremy Burnett. And we'll take a look at Tuffy Rhodes, a 3-2 curveball out over the plate, and Rhodes just puts a charge into it. Yeah, with the wind blowing out, no doubt about this, all Thompson does is look up.
You know, that was to the curveball to the outside portion of the plate, and he hit it almost directly center field in the right, in the center field section of the left field bleachers, right where the two bleachers join. Here's Grace. Fastball low and inside.
Now this is from the rooftop camera, the southwest rooftop camera. And it's out over the plate away from him. He gets his arms out, and no doubt about that swing.
Now last year, Tuffy hit. There goes a runner. Swung and fouled. Outside first base. The hit and run was on. You know, Rhodes last year started with Omaha at Kansas City Foreign Club, and he hit 23. Then he's traded to the Cubs, and he went over to Iowa, where he had 7 home runs, giving him a total of 30. Then he joined the Cubs, and long enough to hit 3 homers. So actually, he had a total of 33 home runs last year. Double play ball is sharp. This guy, you know, over the second, over the first, and Graves has grounded into a double play. 6-4-3. And that brings up Derek May.
Last year, Mark Grace grounded into 20-some double plays, and this year they tried the hit and run. It was not successful, and Mark Grace grounds into his first double play.
Here's Derek May, 1-0 in favor of the Cup. Curveball in there, a strike call. And Doc Gooden has a fine number two going for him, even though one of them was hit for a home run. Way outside. One ball, one strike.
Last year was not the typical Gooden year, as he really struggled. He went just 12-15, an ERA 3.45, and completed 7 of his 29 starts.
There's a smash, line drive. On one hop, right to Gooden, who throws Derek May out to retire on the side. One run, two hits, no errors, one left. At the end of one, Cubs lead 1-0.
Hair, such an underappreciated gift. Just look what you do to it. You sacrifice it. You wear it up. You cut it yourself.
You like it?
No.
Yet there's still one place that cares more about your hair than you will ever know.
Show-offs.
Relive the gripping excitement of the Cubs' run for the ring as we bring you each game leading up to the 2016 World Series victory. Beginning this Wednesday, Marquee Sports Network will replay a game nightly from the entire 2016 postseason run. Don't miss any game from this special Cubs Classic series. Cubs Classics, 2016 Run for the Ring, premieres this Wednesday at 7 on Marquee Sports Network.
Done yet?
Yeah, sorry, sorry.
You sure?
Mm-hmm. Come on,
wild thing. If you ride, you get it. Geico Motorcycle. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
MS does suck.
MS mucks with your central nervous system. Almost everything about your body, your muscles, your organs, your ability to speak, your ability to understand, your ability to move.
MS took everything from me, everything I thought was important, everything I valued.
I used to jump in a trampoline and swim with the kids.
MS has affected me being a mom because I'm sorry.
Despite MS, I will keep riding my bike.
I will continue to be the strongest mom that I possibly can.
I will still dance with my husband.
I will continue to live the life that my daughter expects me to live.
Multiple sclerosis may be a part of who you are, but it doesn't define you.
I will never stop. I will never quit.
I'm going to keep being me.
I got 7 dogs.
Welcome to Bay versus Ballplayer.
Cubs win on a grand slam by Hayward.
You need something you can run to that makes you happy.
I think everybody hopes to play forever.
We're mic'd up. I tried to play Fortnite. I downloaded it. No chance.
No.
Catch the best Cub moments every month with the Best of Cubs YouTube on Marquee Sports Network.
Harry Carey and Steve Stone as we go in the top of the second. David Segee, the first baseman of the Mets, leading it off. His dad was a major league pitcher. There's a hot smash on the ground. Great play by Sam. Out at first base. Holy cow. What a tremendous play. Ryan Sandberg takes a base hit away from David Segee.
From the scoreboard camera, we'll take a look at some good range to his right as Segee, bidding for a base hit in his first at bat in the National League, finds out what so many other National Leaguers have found out, and that is that Ryan Sandberg is as good as it gets at second base. And he doesn't seem to have lost anything.
There's a high fly ball. Who's going to grab it? Derek May is there. Two up, two down. Here's Ryan Thompson. Want to wish Mark Euler a happy birthday today. Around the Cub infield, Bouchel at third. Dunston at short. Sandberg at second. Grace at first. There is no better defensive infield in the league. With a fine catcher, Rick Wilkins behind the plate. By the way, speaking of Sean Dunston, who's just been an electrifying ball player all spring. He wanted to be sure to be mentioned to his youngsters, Whitney and Jasmine. Whitney and Jasmine Dunston, listening to the ball game back home in the Bay Area. By the way, this is Jasmine's fourth birthday. Bouncing ball, Dunston up. Watch his arm. In time, 1-2-3. And Jasmine, your daddy just made another fine play. We go into the bottom of the second, 1-0 Cubs.
A typical day at Wrigley Field.
As Chicago natives would say, it was a beautiful early May day.
A flame-throwing Cubs rookie.
We have a treat for you today. Youngster from Texas will take the mound.
A game that made history.
This is what everybody comes for, to hopefully come to that special game.
Here comes the hook. Down there, 20 strikeouts.
Kerry Wood 20, Sunday at 10 on Marquee Sports Network. Marquee Sports Network presents Cubs Classics. Mark Grace, opening day. Relive the action of this 1996 season opener against San Diego.
Cubs win!
With memories and analysis from the experts. Cubs Classics, Mark Grace, opening day, today at 12 on Marquee Sports Network.
We've always had villains to face.
Bad guys to take down. But you.
You're worse than all of them put together. You are the most horrible of all.
Pure evil.
But just because you're tough.
Doesn't mean we can't beat you.
We're not here because we have to be. We're here because we've had enough of you.
Every single one of us is mortal.
Even me.
But inside of us,
we're all heroes. One person is not a team.
But when we join together.
Together. You don't stand a chance.
We are glorious. We are resilient.
And we will win.
So stand up with us. Stand up to fight.
To stand up to cancer. Visit standuptocancer.org to learn more.
Relive the gripping excitement of the Cubs' run for the ring as we bring you each game leading up to the 2016 World Series victory. Beginning this Wednesday, Marquee Sports Network will replay a game nightly from the entire 2016 postseason run. Don't miss any game from this special Cubs Classic series. Cubs Classics, 2016 Run for the Ring, premieres this Wednesday at 7 on Marquee Sports Network.
No one should face breast cancer alone. I'm Janelle Hale, founder and CEO of the National Breast Cancer Foundation. When I was diagnosed in 1980, there was no internet and little information available to make an informed decision. Today at NBCF, we help women at every step of their breast cancer journey. Early detection saved my life. It could save yours too. Learn more at nbcf.org/hope.
Harry Carey and Steve Stone, we go on to the bottom of the second. Here's Sammy Sagee to lead it off. Fastball inside. Boy, Gooden seems to have good stuff. They clocked his fastball about 94 miles an hour this spring. Ooh, he had a cut. And the count evens up.
When you look at the record of Doc Gooden over the years, you see the strikeout totals go down and down. So he's not going to be able to be the same dominating pitcher he was before. But he's got to do it a little differently these days. But that fastball is still popping.
There's a good fastball over the outside corner. One ball, two strikes.
Sosa had a magnificent spring where he hit 7 home runs. And this young man has as lively a bat as you'll see on this club.
Good now, 29 years old. The pit, foul back. Well, there we have the Cub bullpen. There's Bautista there. Then next to him is Bollinger and Ilsley, and there is Sean Boskey. One ball, two strikes. Curveball in there, a beauty. Boy, how can you hit that curveball?
That was a knee buckler.
And not only those ball players coming to town, but my son Skip. Skip Carey will be here. There's the pitch. Outside. Rick Wilkins had an outstanding spring. Had a great season a year ago.
Harry Gooden just showed you why you have to have some left-hand hitters in the lineup when you're facing him. That knee-buckling curveball to Sosa,
yeah,
for a right-hand hitter, that's death.
High foul ball out of play. A capacity crowd, that's nothing unusual here at Wrigley Field. Well, I see my good friend Ben Stein has recuperated and out of the hospital watching the ball game here today. One ball, two strikes. He's here with Jack Leahy. There's Charlie Brumback to the right of the first lady and Stanton Cook to her left. I don't know that that's has any political implications. One ball, two strikes. Watch Gooden. A little bit outside.
Looks, boy, to me like
around that plate.
It looks to me like Wilkins should look for something away from Doc Gooden. If he gets a fastball away, a lot like Tuffy Rhodes, he can take it out in left center.
Curve high. 3-2. The White Sox at Toronto are tied 1-1 at the end of 3. Rhodes got the first home run. There's a line drive, hit hard, but going to be caught. Jeremy Burnett's grab Wilkins' hot line drive. Two gone. Bump Wills, I think, in 1982, led off the season's opener with a home run in Montreal. as I recall. And now just Tuffy Rhodes has done it again in 94. Here's Michelle. 1-0 Cubs. Fastball high. Pete Smith will go tomorrow. Pitch is in there, a strike call. There's Mike Morgan to the left of Ryan Sandberg. Curveball in there. 1-2. The Wade, goodness, pitching. Morgan's going to have to be his best also. A tap on the ground. And Kent throws him out. 1-2-3. At the end of 2, the Cubs lead 1-0.
Bad hair day? Try no hair day. And at least you can check in online, walk into a Supercuts, and get a fresh haircut. You know what happens when I walk into a Supercuts?
I don't.
They just assume I'm looking for the karate studio next door. This guy knows what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Hello world, here's the road that we're taking.
Come on, get healthy.
Working together, there's a goal that we're making to keep us healthy.
With the new LiveWell app from Advocate Aurora, it's easy to make healthy happen anytime, anywhere.
Traveling along,
here's a place that we're going.
Come on, get healthy. Come on, get healthy.
Are you in a job you can't stand? Do you want a rewarding career with great growth potential?
What a career in IT means to me is unlimited options. Before my computer career, I was struggling to make ends meet.
You don't have to have any form of IT experience when you walk into this campus.
They guide you every step of the way to help you find your dream job.
I want this, and I can do this.
Train for a better life at mycomputercareer.edu. Go to mycomputercareer.edu and fill out the free career evaluation right now.
We are T-Mobile, the first to go unlimited. First with no annual service contracts. First with taxes and fees included. Now T-Mobile has the first and only nationwide 5G network, reaching over 5,000 cities and towns and over 200 million Americans. And T-Mobile is not charging extra for 5G access. Because this isn't our network, it's yours.
Sir, you cannot park there.
What? Why?
It's reserved for Chris Paul.
Barb, tell me what you not see.
My name's not Barb. You're not Chris Paul.
Stop it, Nancy. Woo!
That's not my name.
Can I see some ID?
This is my ID.
Need a tow truck on level one? Oh, it's Jake from State Farm.
Here's the deal. There's no replacing the real Chris Paul, just like there's no replacing State Farm.
Miley, who took my spot?
Oh, just some guy. We're taking care of it.
Okay.
You want the real deal? Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
This is the Frells family's land. When the first snow fell, the kids went sledding right there. This used to be a shed. Now, it's where they get breakfast. This is more than just land. It's home. The Frells family runs with us on a John Deere 1 Series tractor. Because land isn't the only thing that should live on for generations. Nothing runs like a deer. Search John Deere 1 Series for more. Get a 1 Series tractor starting at $99 per month.
Bonnie Blair is I Live and Dream, the world's greatest ice skater. How do you navigate without ice skates on?
Oh, I don't know. I try to do my best, but that's definitely where I feel most comfortable.
Well, congratulations. What a great, great year you had, huh?
Yeah, definitely. I don't think it could have gone any better, really. It was, last year was so-so, and I didn't know whether I'd have a good year this year, but boy, it was way better than I expected.
Well, when are you going to skate next?
Well, I'll have some time off right now, and then our dry land training won't start up again till about the end of May. Back on the ice in September, my first competition will be about the end of November, and then our world championships will be in Milwaukee in February.
Well, listen, congratulations to you. Nice to have you here. You can go back to your boyfriend now and thank him for imposing, for us imposing on you.
All right, thanks. Thank you, dear. Thanks, it's been nice.
Bonnie Blair, what a sweet little gal she is. Dunson has thrown out a good hitting pitcher, Dwight Gooden, one away. And there's another thing to remember your daddy by, Jasmine, on your fourth birthday. His daughter, Jasmine Dunston, 4 years old today. And Sean, I think thinking more about the two youngsters back in the Bay Area than actually the opening game of the season. He's done this before. Here's a pitch swung on. There's a drive by Vizcaino. It's going to be out of here. It is! The former Cub really drilled one high in the right field. He circles the bases, and this game is all tied up.
Vizcaino hit two home runs for the Cubs in spring training. And strangely enough, he gets a big hand from the crowd here. So Jose was a crowd favorite as a member of the Cubs. Nothing has changed now that he's a member of the Mets, and he ties up the game at one. It came from an unlikely source, but he's paying early dividends to his new employers, the New York Mets. He gets a fastball out over the plate and just drills it. Sammy Sosa looks up, but this one is against the back screen.
And here is Todd Huntley, who fanned in the first inning. This game all tied up. And the two leadoff men are responsible. Tuffy Rhodes led off the first with a home run off Doc Gooden. And Jose Vizcaino with one out here in the third. There's another drive way back. It might be. It is Todd Huntley. It's another home run. Back-to-back homers, and the Mets lead 2-1. He got that fastball to the inside part of the plate again.
Well, last year, I thought the Cubs learned something about Todd Huntley, and that was to throw him a lot of off-speed pitches and a lot of breaking balls. Because last year, the only time they got him out was on slow curves and changeups. Morgan went with the fastball, and of course, Huntley has always hit the Cubs very well because they've seemingly thrown him a lot of hittable fastballs, and he showed Mike Morgan that he could turn on one. So back-to-back home runs have given the Mets a 2-1 lead.
Jeff Kemp, the second baseman, another home run threat. He hit 21. Bonilla hit 34. Reynolds is up there now. He hit 11 in the American League last year. And he was considered a home run hitter in the old Met lineup when he was with them the first time around. One ball, one strike.
Kevin.
Inside. Two balls and a strike.
Take a look one more time and watch the hands of young Todd Huntley. He gets a fastball. This one tailed back over the plate. Morgan wanted it inside and it didn't get there.
Pitch fouled off, 2-2. Morgan throws a pretty good sinker. Usually, when he's right, he gets a lot of ground balls hit. In this inning, two got up in that wind. There's a high pop fly going out for it. Mark Graves makes the catch. Two away. And here's Bobby Bonilla. Fan his first time up. Now here's a guy you fear the long ball from. Vizcaino and Huntley really don't hit that many, but they sure did today. And that's the thing about baseball. They talk about statistics. What's happened has already happened. What's important is now. One ball, one strike. Good pitch over the outside corner.
Now, the last time that Morgan struck out Bonilla, he did it with a curveball in the dirt. And he's ahead of him 1-2. Let's see if he goes back there one more time.
Fastball inside. Bonilla took it. And the count is even. 2-1 in favor of the Mets. that come out? Over the inside corner of fastball. So, two runs, two hits, no errors, nobody left. We go in the bottom of the third, 2-1 in favor of New York.
Cadillac invites you to move up in the world at the Cadillac Move Up sales event. Move up to available Wi-Fi hotspot capability. Move up to cutting-edge design. Move up to something a little more, well, Cadillac. Make your way to your nearest Cadillac showroom today. During the Move Up sales event, get this low-mileage lease on this 2020 Cadillac XT5 for around $419 per month.
People from Chicago pull for Chicago. We root for its teams, celebrate its successes, push through its challenges. When people call us the second city, it's misleading. We're second to none. We're hardworking, resilient, but we have a good time. When you live in Chicago, you proudly call this home. Your bank should too. We're Wintrust, built here for here. And we've taken our place as Chicago's bank because no other bank can say the same.
The census. A special time when we count every person in each home in every neighborhood.
Do kids count?
Of course. Counting everyone in your home helps support your neighborhood by funding things like schools, hospitals, and buses. Complete the census by calling or going online, or return your form by mail.
It's easy, secure, and most important, it's totally private.
Make your family count!
This year, make sure every child counts. Visit 2020census.gov.
Great weather, great friends. You just saved a bunch of money by switching your boat insurance to Geico.
It was easy.
Folks, can it get any better than this?
Is that what I think it is?
That is an armada of tiny sushi boats.
Awesome! I forgot to pack lunch!
You had one job. Oh, chopsticks, wasabi, and soy. Coming in a little hot.
It only gets better when you switch and save with Geico.
Join Marquee Sports Network for Cubs 360.
All right, okay. Let's enjoy ourselves. They're a very talented team, the Chicago Cubs, and a very talented division.
Once you start eliminating hit and runs, bunts, all these other ways to create action, you're just sitting back for basically the three-run home run.
That's what accountability is that knowing you're given everything you have that day to win, because so am I.
I think the Cubs can win this division. I don't see why not. I really don't.
Cubs 360, Monday at 6 on Marquee Sports Network.
It's about winning championships. It's about holding yourself accountable to the things that you've found in winning. You know, I've been a part of winning almost my entire life, and I know what that looks like. And those are the expectations that I'm going to hold those guys accountable to.
I'm Javi Baez, and you're watching Marquee Sports Network.
Governor Edgar is with us. Governor, what were you saying to the First Lady? A Republican governor talking to a Democratic First Lady.
Well, we're both from Illinois, and we're talking about the Cubs. It's a great day. It's great to have her here, and it's great to be here with you, Harry. In fact, I'm here to present you with a proclamation. I, as governor today, have proclaimed this Harry Carey Day in the state of Illinois.
Well, thank you
for the 50 years of enjoyment you provided people all over the state.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that very much.
And we look forward to another 50 years.
I'm in favor of that, sir. Thank you very much.
Again, just thank you and congratulations. I don't know many people are going to stay in the same job 50 years, but that means you're awful good.
I've been in the same rut for a long time, right?
Well, you're in a pretty good rut.
thank you very much,
congratulations,
sir.
And good luck with the Cubs this year. We need to do some work here.
Thank you. We got to get some runs.
That's right.
All right. Thank you very much.
Count goes to 0-2 on Sean Dunson as Gooden delivers.
Pop fly, gonna be caught, hey! But he makes a catch. Boy, oh boy, Jeff Kent slipped. Jesse's gonna catch the ball, fell down, reached while on the ground and caught it. One away, good play.
Well, last year this was a terrible defense for the Mets. This year they think they've made it a little bit better with the addition of David Segee. And Jeff Kent just shows you some acrobatics as he dives, rolls over, but still makes the play. So with the wind blowing out, you have to realize that everything that's hit down the line is going to blow back toward the field of play. Kent almost overran that ball.
So there's one away. And here's Mike Morgan. Pretty good hitting pitcher himself. 2-1 Mets. A hurried attack. Two swings, two runs. Foul ball outside first. 0-2. Well, let's see what Aflac has for us this year on the first game of the season. What is the Cubs' longest winning streak to start a season? My guess would have to be B. What's your?
Okay, well, you guess B already. I'll say C.
There's a pitch, strike call.
Mike Cook is here along with Dick Wilkins and Irv Siegel. They are the Chicagoland, Indiana Buick dealers, all at the home opener today.
Well, here's Tuffy Rhodes. He's been the whole attack. Cubs have only two hits. One of them a homer by Rhodes to start the ball game for the Cubs, who now trail 2-1. Tom Brennan will be along at the end of this half inning. 2 men are out. Fastball outside. Rhodes hit a total of 33 homers with three different clubs last year. Three of them in the major leagues.
He's scared of you, Puff.
Well, let's see what the answer is. Hey, I'm finally right. Two balls, no strikes, two out. Pitch a little bit outside.
Now, Rhodes drew 11 bases on balls in spring training, had over a 400 on base percentage, and that's what you look for from a leadoff hitter.
There's a strike call. John Sender on hand here today. Three balls and the strike. Long drive, way back, it might be, it could be, it is. Holy cow! Tuffy Road has hit two of them, of Doc Gooden. Listen to this crowd.
Well, I guess you couldn't ask for a better leadoff hitter. It's a Ricky Henderson clone.
And you know, he worked the count to three balls and a strike again. This time he hit a 3-1 pitch.
Well, this time instead of the curveball that he hit out of the park, he hit a fastball. Same result, a 2-2 game. And Tuffy Rhodes has thrilled this huge opening day crowd.
Listen to the crowd. Boy, oh boy. And I mean, they both were hit well. Smile, Tuffy, come on. Here's a pitch, a curveball. Boy, he's not showing the elation he must be feeling. Hot shot on the ground. Kemp has it. Over to first. One run, one hit. No error, nobody left. Harry Carey from Wrigley Field. We're at the end of three. The game is tied up, a battle of homers. Mets 2, Cubs 2.
Your brain is an amazing thing, but as you get older, it naturally begins to change, causing a lack of sharpness or even trouble with recall. Thankfully, the breakthrough in Prevagen helps your brain and actually improves memory. The secret is an ingredient originally discovered in jellyfish. In clinical trials, Prevagen has been shown to improve short-term memory. Prevagen, healthier brain, better life.
Sales have been booming. When can I expect to receive?
They want 20,000 cases?
21,000.
We don't have the capacity.
I know.
But we'll figure it out.
I know.
Introducing small business banking from First Midwest Bank. With financing to help your business expand, you have plans, we have ideas. Let's talk at a First Midwest branch today.
A typical day at Wrigley Field.
As Chicago natives would say, it was a beautiful early May day.
A flame-throwing Cubs rookie.
We have a treat for you today. Youngster from Texas will take the mound.
a game that made history.
What can you say?
This is what everybody comes for, to hopefully come to that special game.
Here comes the hook.
Kerry Wood 20, Sunday at 10 on Marquee Sports Network.
When America's service members move forward, they're unstoppable. Unstoppable in their mission. Since 2003, Wounded Warrior Project has advocated for these heroes. Our mission is helping injured veterans achieve their highest ambition with free services in mental health, career counseling, and long-term rehabilitative care. And warriors never pay a penny for our programs. They're unstoppable heroes. Support warriors today at woundedwarriorproject.org.
We've always had villains to face.
Bad guys to take down. But you?
You are the most horrible of all.
We're not here because we have to be.
We're here because we've had enough of you.
Every single one of us is mortal.
But inside of us, we're all heroes.
So stand up with us. Stand up to fight.
Stand up to cancer.
Visit standuptocancer.org to learn more.
Welcome back to Wrigley Field, opening day 94, a 2-2 game, and that will change on one swing of the bat. Jeff Kent has played long ball. All five runs today have come via home runs. And New York all of a sudden has taken a 3-2 lead. That pitch was hammered.
Tommy, anytime Mike Morgan gets the ball waist high or above, that sinker flattens out, and that ball goes a long way, and we've seen it today. The big guy hasn't hit it. Bobby Bonilla, the man you think about hitting home runs, hasn't. Three other guys have.
Well, it's nice to see you again, pal.
And it's nice to see you,
we
too,
we wondered if you'd be back for opening day with Steve Stone and our producer-director, Arnie Harris. I'm Tom Brenneman. Welcome to opening day 94, and it's been a very exciting game so far. We've had more runs today than we had in the first two games in the first of last season.
Well, just taking a look at Tuffy Rhodes hitting two home runs against none other than Doc Gooden has to thrill this overflow crowd.
Carl Rhodes has said he feels a little pressure coming into this season, taking over the leadoff chore, the everyday center field job, but you wouldn't know it by today. Two at-bats, two home runs against perhaps a future Hall of Famer in Doc Gooden. David Segee, the batter, had a very fine year for Baltimore last season, but after they acquired Rafael Palmeiro, there was nowhere for Segee to play. And the Mets will take advantage of that. He's a pretty solid player, very good defensively.
Well, he comes from good bloodlines. His father, Diego Segee, a former pitcher, said that David didn't have the temperament to be a pitcher. He said if they made an error behind him, he would just blow up. So they decided to put him at first base. And here he is, a major leaguer.
But, and there is ball four to Segee. So a leadoff home run by Kent. And now four straight out of the zone. And Dallas Green has a man aboard.
Tommy, the Mets needed a first baseman. They had Eddie Murray. They decided to go in a different direction. This is a team that literally nobody picks to contend this year, so they felt that they had to get a little more youth on their ball club. Eddie Murray now with the Cleveland Indians, a team that's going to contend. As we take a look at Tom Treblehorn looking out, and Tommy, I sort of noticed what kind of a year it would be by immediately spilling your water as you came in all over your scorebook.
I was getting ready to say, you couldn't have dumped it all over your scorebook or your papers. It had to be all over mine. And that's ripped into right field, down in the corner for Burnett. On his way to third is Segee. Burnett's going to second. Here comes a throw, not in time. So Morgan in deep, deep trouble to open the fourth inning. A home run by Kent, a walk to Segee, and now a double by Jeremy Burnett.
A lot of people on the New York Mets organization figured that certainly pitching would be a problem, but also how Burnett and Thompson would hit at the bottom of the order. Now, Jeremy Burnett is very strong, and last year he showed that he could hit the ball out of the park. What he has to show is he can hit it a little more consistently, and right there he rifles a double down the line. We'll take a look at Jeff Kent, who hit 21 of them last year. He got that fastball. If you looked at the location, it was high and away. He turned on it, and with the wind blowing out at Wrigley Field, it was a long home run. And so now meeting at the mound, bullpen up and going.
Blaze Hillsley starting to get loose, a left-hander who has never pitched in the major leagues, but he threw pretty well this spring, and he made it just ahead of left-hander Dave Otto.
Well, Tom, if you look at his numbers, when he first started with Houston, he was rated as their number one prospect in the organization. He had staggering numbers in the minor leagues, but that was before he hurt his arm. He has learned to be a completely different pitcher when the fastball got cut back about 6-8 miles an hour.
So now with the Mets runners at second and third, it'll be center fielder Ryan Thompson. Dwight Gooden is on deck. Grace is even with the bag over at first. And Bouchel about a step behind it over at third. And a good knockdown there by Wilkins to keep the runner David Segee at third base. If you're just tuning in, first batter of the season for the Cubs, Carl Rhodes. A home run to left center. Then in the third inning, Vizcaino and Hundley. They're not supposed to do that. Just based on principle, those two guys, they went back-to-back for home runs. Rhodes another long ball to tie it. And Ken a leadoff home run here in the inning. And now the Mets will take the lead even bigger. Down the line, Segee coming in. Burnett will score. May having trouble down in the corner. And going in with a two-run double is Ryan Thompson. And the Mets have now extended their lead to three.
Well, now the entire trade that sent David Cone to Toronto a couple of years back and yielded Jeff Kent and Ryan Thompson has come back to haunt the Cubs. Both Kent and Thompson with extra base hits. That's a couple of RBIs for Ryan Thompson. And hitting in the eighth spot, it looks like he's going to be a force to be reckoned with this year as the Mets have taken a three-run lead.
Dwight Gooden, a very good hitter. The Cubs, however, figuring he's trying to get the runner down to third with a bunt. Grace way in over at first. They let him at least swing away, but he looks at a pitch down low. So the Mets in front, 5-2 here in the top of the fourth inning. One and 0 to Gooden. And again, Grace in on the grass at first. Gooden showing no sign of laying down a bunt. He looks at a strike.
Well, Gooden, one of the best hitting pitchers in the National League. You'd probably rank him along with Oral Hershiser. A couple of other fellas in that. Greg Maddux, another guy who can hit. But Dwight Gooden likes to do his own hitting. Doesn't mean that Dallas Green is not going to give him the bunt as you look at Bobby Wine to his right, his aide de camp in the dugout.
And this time Gooden will bunt, and it's a beauty. Morgan's only play is to Sandberg covering at first. Down to third goes Ryan Thompson. So Doc Gooden, not only a great pitcher, but a complete player. As you mentioned, he swings a bat. He's a very good bunter. He runs exceptionally well. And when you do that, you're going to help yourself in the win department. And now I have some new water, thank goodness.
And a dry book on top of it all.
No, that's not dry.
Semi-dry book?
Semi, maybe. Thank you again. All right, a runner at third. And here's Vizcaino. He's been aboard twice. He homered to right field back in the third inning and looks at a strike against a drawn-in infield.
And you figure three runs down with only one out, you draw in the infield to cut off a man at the plate. And hopefully, in this situation, you'll have the ball on the ground as Morgan has had trouble keeping the ball down. He needs a ground ball in this situation.
Pitch on the way, and it missed outside. 1-1 to Vizcaino. Well, Jose asked us to send out the best to his wife. They're about to have a little baby here in the next few days. In fact, she's going to stay right here in Chicago to have the child before going to New York. And this will get a run in. Maybe. Derek May setting himself. Here comes Thompson. Here comes a throw, not nearly in time, and the Mets have extended the lead to 6-3. And Vizcaino, the former Cub, has come back to haunt him today. He's already knocked in a pair.
Morgan trying to get the ground ball. Instead, Vizcaino gets the job done. Now, Ryan Thompson is not a base-stealing threat, but he does have very good speed, and he easily beats the throw from Derek May. So the Mets have a four-run lead. And this has usually been the case when Dwight Gooden goes to the mound. When the Cubs do hit Gooden, the Mets seem to score a lot more. That's the reason for the 26-4 lifetime record that Gooden sports against the Cubs.
26-4. Those numbers are almost too hard to believe. And an ERA of 3.16, so he's getting a few people out in the process.
Yes.
1-1 to Hundley.
Strange story about Todd Hundley. Kelly Stinnett beat him out in spring training. But here against the Cubs, Hundley starts because of his great success. Not only against the Cubs, but personally against Mike Morgan. He came in hitting over 400 against him.
And it looks like a pretty good move so far. Hundley with a home run down the right field line against Morgan back in the third inning. But you brought it up. Kelly Stinnett in the Rule 5 draft coming over from Cleveland looks to be the everyday catcher. That'll end the inning, but a big one for New York. Four runs, three hits, nobody left. We're in the middle of the fourth inning, opening day, Wrigley Field, Chicago, and a four-run Mets advantage.
Relive the gripping excitement of the Cubs' run for the ring as we bring you each game leading up to the 2016 World Series victory. Beginning this Wednesday, Marquee Sports Network will replay a game nightly from the entire 2016 postseason run. Don't miss any game from this special Cubs Classic series. Cubs Classics, 2016 Run for the Ring, premieres this Wednesday at 7 on Marquee Sports Network.
And we've upgraded her with the Sonic Shield and holographic mapping drones.
Impressive.
There is one more thing.
Ah, Jake from State Farm.
Here's the deal. With the Drive Safe and Save app, you'll also get rewarded for being a safe driver.
Now that is an upgrade.
Well played, Jake from State Farm. As usual.
When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
No one should face breast cancer alone. I'm Janelle Hale, founder and CEO of the National Breast Cancer Foundation. When I was diagnosed in 1980, there was no internet and little information available to make an informed decision. Today at NBCF, we help women at every step of their breast cancer journey. Early detection saved my life. It could save yours too. Learn more at nbcf.org/hope.
When your psoriasis is bad, it can be hard to see what's possible. But the possibilities become clear with Taltz. The first and only treatment of its kind offering a chance at 100% clear skin. With Taltz, up to 90% of those with moderate to severe psoriasis saw a significant improvement of their psoriasis plaques. Some even saw 100% clear skin. Don't use if you're allergic to Taltz. Before starting, get checked for tuberculosis. Increased risk of infections and lower ability to fight them may occur. Tell your doctor about infections, symptoms, or if inflammatory bowel disease symptoms develop, worsen, or if you've had a vaccine or plan to. Serious allergic reactions can occur. See the possibilities. Ask your doctor about Taltz.
I'm Jason Hayward.
I'm Chris Bryant.
I'm Javi Baez.
And you're watching Marquee Sports Network.
Marquee Sports Network presents Cubs Classics, Mark Grace Opening Day. Relive the action of this 1996 season opener against San Diego.
Cubs win! Cubs win! Cubs win! Holy cow! Mark Grace came through!
With memories and analysis from the experts. Cubs Classics, Mark Grace Opening Day, today at 12 on Marquee Sports Network.
And the Cubs need a little help offensively against Doc Gooden. It'll be Grace, Derek May, and Sammy Sosa. A 6-2 New York lead, and there's a base hit for Grace into right field, his first of the afternoon. And the fourth against Gooden. Two of the four home runs by Carl Rhodes. I'm having a tough time calling him Carl. I used to grow up playing basketball against him, and I've always known him as Carl, but his mother calls him Tuffy. He likes being called Tuffy, so that's the way I guess it'll have to be.
You have to call him Tuffy because the way he hit those first two balls, I wouldn't want to see him pounding any knots on your coconut.
Thank you very much. I wouldn't either. He keeps hitting home runs. We'll call him whatever he wants to be called. That's a foul ball by Derek May.
Derek May did not have many swings in spring training, and I talked to Tom Treblehorn about that fact, and they said that while he wasn't able to run, he still was swinging the bat in the batting cage, so they don't feel that it's going to affect him at all. He had some good swings late, but he had very few game opportunities to swing the bat.
Tom Treblehorn, of course, his managerial debut, at least in the regular season here today, did a fine job in Milwaukee, finished very strong his last year there, going 40-19 over the last 59 games, but the club did not make postseason, and they figured they needed a change. Been on the staff here ever since, and now takes over, and I think has won over many of the players who were a little skeptical after the firing of Jim Lefevre. There's a drive into center. Thompson keeps going back, and it's off the wall. Grace being waved around third. Here comes a throw home, and it's cut off. Now they have May caught. And a throw to Vizcaino, and they'll get him there. But the run does score, give May the RBI two-base hit. And that makes it a 6-3 ball game with New York in front.
Well, it goes as the first RBI for Derek May, and he turns around Ryan Thompson. You don't like to see base running like this because if you stay at second base, there's nobody out in the inning, and you've got a shot to get to Dwight Gooden. Now, Mark Grace is going to score, and I'm not sure what was on the mind of Derek May, who is not running particularly well, but being hung out to dry here, the play is easy. And Derek is out. That could turn out to be a pretty big run. However, the Cubs do get one, and they now trail by three.
One down, base is empty, and Sammy Sosa, a big cut and a foul ball back. Gooden got him looking on strikes back in the second inning. The wind is blowing out, and generally, six runs does not win a game in the friendly confines with those kind of conditions. Generally.
The one thing you try to do, if you can, is get into that bullpen, because that was the sore spot for the Mets all of last year. And although they say John Franco is entirely healthy, that still remains to be seen.
Here's the 0-2 to Sosa, and a little tardy on the Gooden fastball. It's out of play.
Now, they really haven't done a whole lot to shore up that bullpen. They needed some help in middle relief. What they did was bring in Pete Smith in the starting rotation. That's going to help them. And you see the winning percentages of the Mets as the ERAs have started to climb, the winning percentages have started to descend.
That's no real surprise.
Pretty much goes hand in hand.
Yeah, you follow this game long enough, if the ERA is climbing, the losses are dwindling.
Well, the Mets also didn't score very much last year. They had some big offensive problems. They lost 103 games.
2-2 now to Sosa. No problem with their offense here today against Mike Morgan. Six runs and a 6-3 lead here in the bottom of the fourth inning. We invite you to be with us all summer long here on Channel 9 for Cubs baseball. It should be a fun summer. Cubs figure to score lots of runs. And Sosa's out on strikes for the second time today. Third strikeout for Dwight Gooden. You agree about the point I made with Tom Treblehorn? I know a lot of the players were in favor of Jimmy Lefevre and bringing him back, but I think Treblehorn has won many of them over with the kind of camp he ran in Arizona.
Well, I think he ran an outstanding camp, and I think they took a look at the dedication of which Tom Treblehorn approached this spring and realized that he was trying to make them a better team. I think they liked the more offensive game that Tom Treblehorn played in the spring. The Cubs ran a lot more. They tried to do a lot more in execution. They bunted a lot more. I think they spent a lot more time on fundamentals this spring, and you're right. I think this team enjoys having Treblehorn at the helm.
Weak roller to short. Vizcaino waited, backhands, and did he have enough? No, the ball is dropped by Segui. Short hop throw over there, and Segui generally very good with a glove, but that was a tough one to handle. Vizcaino may have waited one bounce too many.
Well, I think they're going to give Wilkins a hit on this. This is a pretty tough play. It comes off with a lot of spin, and Jose is caught in between. No, they're going to give him an air, and that's kind of surprising. It's a bang-bang play at first. If Segui picks it clean, he probably has him by a half step. And as it turned out, looks like they gave him an error, but they put a hit up on the board, so.
Well, we're waiting to find out. I thought it should have been ruled an error, because if Segui handles a throw, of course, they would give the throwing error to Vizcaino because it's in the dirt, but if he picks it up, Wilkins would have been out. Well, nevertheless, we can debate that, and I'm sure we will all summer long with our good friend Bob Rosenberg. The official score here at Wrigley Field. And it is an error. We understand a throwing error has been charged to Jose Vizcaino. Bouchel grounded out to second base his first time up. And we're starting to get a little closer to Mike Morgan's spot in the order. With only one man out, and Blaze Ilsley is again throwing down in the Cub bullpen.
We can understand that. Number one, early in the season. Number two, you don't get many shots at Dwight Gooden. If this inning is still alive when you get down to Morgan's spot, you certainly want to bring somebody off the bench.
And there's a bouncing ball that will sneak through into left field, a base hit for Bouchel. So with two down, the Cubs have two on, and Sean Dunston is coming up.
We see how damaging the base running mistake by Derek May turned out to be. The Cubs could have at least had four at this point and a big inning still in place. As it is, there's a couple of outs. As we go back and take a look at Jose Vizcaino, the one thing that Jose doesn't have is a whole lot of range at shortstop. He's very sure-handed. He's got a good strong arm. But he didn't have the range of either Dunston or Sanchez at short. Now, when they talked about Anthony Young, and a lot of other teams wanted Anthony Young, I am certain that there was a choice given to Joe McElvain as far as who he wanted. He thought that the most complete player, and by the choice, I'm talking about Hernandez, Sanchez, or Vizcaino. Mm-hmm. I think he felt the most complete player for his team was Vizcaino, and that's who he wanted.
I agree with him. Two on, two out. Cubs are down 6-3 against Doc Gooden, the Mets, here in opening day 94. Dunston, the batter, he popped to second his only time up. He looks at a strike. Dunston had a spectacular spring.
Eddie Zambrano in the on-deck circle, so they will indeed take down Mike Morgan if Sean Dunston can keep it alive.
Zambrano earning an opening day roster spot with a very fine spring. And, of course, he was the American Association's most valuable player 1 year ago. Good man to have coming off the bench with that bat. The 0-1 to Dunston. High drive. Deep left center field. But it might not be enough. And it's off the wall. One run scores. Bouchel will score. And the Cubs have trimmed it down to one. It looked like a ball that should have been caught.
Well, take a look at Kevin McReynolds as he goes back to what will eventually be the Ivy. This is a towering fly ball to left center. That's home run alley here at Wrigley Field with the wind blowing out. McReynolds goes back, does not play this ball very well. He's very shy of that wall, and that ball hit the bottom of the fence. In that case, for all you young outfielders, get back to the wall and feel for it right away. Get to know where you are in relationship to the wall. Then he would have made the catch easily. As it was, two steps from the wall, he pulled up, and that ball hit at the bottom of the wall, not off the wall. So the Cubs get a break, and they close the gap to one.
One throwing error in the inning by Vizcaino, and although that is ruled a double, certainly not a good defensive play by McReynolds. Here's Zambrano batting for Morgan. Pitch on the way, the tying run at second base, and it's strike one.
Last year, the Mets were just a horrible defensive club, and they thought they did something to shore up the defense by putting Segui at first base. But they still have some guys playing out of position, and anytime you do that, and I'm talking about Bonilla at third, you've got some problems. And McReynolds is proving not to be exactly a gazelle in left.
Foul ball straight back, and it's quickly 0-2 to young Eddie Zambrano. But McReynolds is not out of position.
No, he is a left fielder. But he's, I think, slowed down a little bit as the years have gone. If you remember, Tommy, he sat out the first year of organized ball with a leg problem. And although he hasn't had recurrence of that, I don't think he runs as well as he did when he came up.
Dunston, the tying run at second base, two away. And Zambrano looks at ball one. One ball and two strikes. We're in the bottom of the fourth. New York getting four in the top of the inning. And Gooden, with little help defensively, serving up three thus far here in the bottom of the inning. Two and two. You gotta wonder what's going through the mind of Eddie Zambrano facing a guy like Dwight Gooden. He's probably watched him pitch on TV countless times.
I just think he's looking for something out over the plate because he knows the wind is blowing out today. And this is a hitter's paradise on days when the wind is blowing out.
2-2 pitch. And he struck him out with a high heat. And that'll end the inning. Cubs get three runs, four hits, an error, and one left. We head to the fifth at Wrigley Field. It is a one-run New York lead.
We've always had villains to face.
Bad guys to take down. But you.
You're worse than all of them put together.
You are the most horrible of all.
Pure evil.
But just because you're tough.
Doesn't mean we can't beat you.
We're not here because we have to be. We're here because we've had enough of you.
Every single one of us is mortal.
Even me.
But inside of us,
we're all heroes. One person is not a team.
But when we join together.
Together. You don't stand a chance.
We are glorious. We are resilient.
And we will win.
So stand up with us. Stand up to fight.
Stand up to cancer. Visit standuptocancer.org to learn more.
Marquee Sports Network presents Cubs Classics. Sammy Sosa hits home run numbers 61 and 62 from the extraordinary 1998 season.
Saw that mountain, number 61, move over Maris. Saw that, there she goes, number 62.
Catch Slammin' Sammy swinging to history with memories and analysis from the experts. Cubs Classics premieres Monday at 7 on Marquee Sports Network. Get to know where to place your next bet on Follow the Money on Marquee Sports Network. Vegas veterans Mitch Ross and Paulie Howard host this hour-long show, share their knowledge of sports and gambling.
The Cubs always take money, so it doesn't matter. Everyone would come to town and bet the Cubs win the World Series, no matter who was on the team.
Get the most up-to-date information in live odds, predictions, and betting trends from the sports gambling capital of the world. Follow the Money, weekdays at noon on Marquee Sports Network.
When America's service members move forward, they're unstoppable. Unstoppable in their mission. Since 2003, Wounded Warrior Project has advocated for these heroes. Our mission is helping injured veterans achieve their highest ambition with free services in mental health, career counseling, and long-term rehabilitative care. And warriors never pay a penny for our programs. They're unstoppable heroes. Support warriors today at woundedwarriorproject.org.
Scrolling all day, time can disappear. Wanna make it count? Why not volunteer?
Posting pics of your food, that takes up time.
Time, you've got time to binge all of season 9, though it got so bad.
Time, you've got time. We're gonna grow back and be the same brows you had.
Just a few hours to keep families from harm. Help us end home fires with Sound the Alarm.
Volunteer for a day to install free smoke alarms in your community.
Tom Brenneman, Steve Stone back at Wrigley Field, Chicago. It's opening day, 1994. Of course, the season officially starting last night. Cub fans in Jacksonville, Florida, I'm sure their hero is Rick Wilkins. He has a new battery mate. It's left-hander Blaze Hillsley.
Hillsley came out of the Houston organization. He came out with a blazing fastball, but after he hurt his arm, he had to learn how to pitch. And he usually gets the ball over the plate. That's his strong point. When you look at what he did at Iowa last year at 12-7, and you look at spring training, and it's that spring training that earned him a spot on the ball club. And now he comes in looking at a one-run deficit and against Dwight Gooden, hoping to keep that deficit right there.
He has gone 3-0 on Kevin McReynolds, with Bobby Bonilla due up next. And there is a strike. We mentioned that Ilsley has never pitched an inning in the major leagues. He's bounced around a little. 29-year-old left-hander, born and raised in Michigan. And there's ball four to McReynolds. You don't like having Bobby Bonilla in this ballpark coming up, period, much less with men on base.
Well, the one thing it does set up, if Ilsley can throw the ground ball, as it sets up the double play, because McReynolds doesn't run particularly well, although he does go hard into second base. And Bonilla certainly does not run all that well. So Ilsley looking for the ground ball, preferably to the middle of the diamond. And let's see if he can get it.
Bonilla 0 for 2. He has struck out twice. One swinging, second time looking. And for the first time today, he turns around to bat right-handed. Not a good opening day start for Mike Morgan. Four innings, six hits, six runs, all earned. He walked a couple while fanning four. 1-1 to Bonilla. Bonilla shook off a few of the critics last season with the 34 home runs, the 87 batted in, and he missed a grand total of about 30 games due to a couple of different injuries. Rib cage strain and a very bad shoulder. That one foul down the right field line.
Well, he's still suffering from some rib cage problems, and that has stopped him a little, but the way he's swinging the bat today, it looks like the rib cage isn't bothering him all that much. It's not that I'm not looking for the two strikeouts, but I mean, I'm looking at his swing, and he doesn't seem to be favoring either side. He's taking some pretty good hard cuts. So from the left field camera, we pan in, give you a good look at what Wrigley Field looks like on opening day with the bunting.
High pop fly. Ilsley with a good pitch there to get in on Bonilla. Rhodes coming in, and that's out number one here in the New York fifth. Mets are leading 6-5. A long way to go with a wind blowing out here in the friendly confines. Of course, one big story in baseball last night, well, you all know about the official opening game with St. Louis downing Cincinnati, but many in baseball eyeing the problems of Darryl Strawberry didn't show up yesterday for the Dodgers exhibition game against the Angels. They finally got a hold of him late last night. Runner goes, and Wilkins will have no throw to second base. What do you think happened there?
Well, I think that one we have to chalk up to Blaze Ilsley. He really didn't pay much attention. Then he floated that changeup outside and really gave Wilkins no chance. And unfortunately, this was a hit and run. And Kent, with a pitch about 2 feet outside, just decided not to swing at it.
So McReynolds, the first stolen base for him this season. And Kent, a high fly ball into left center. Wendell get a hold of this. How far? Rhodes at the wall. It's off the ivy. McReynolds had to wait. He'll go to third and stop there. Into second with a double is Kent. So the wind creating lots of problems for outfielders today. And Rhodes, that time, looked like he had a read on it, and then it blew right over his head.
The wind is blowing out rather briskly, and Tuffy Rhodes goes across, really has some problems with it. And Rhodes doesn't have a whole lot of games under his belt in center field here, especially with the wind blowing out. Now, he did play some games in September here, Tommy, but at that time of year, more times than not, the wind blew in. Mm-hmm. So this is a brand new experience for him, and it's going to be an adjustment to play center field, one of the tougher center fields to play with the wind like it is.
Kent 2 out of 3. He homered back in the fourth inning, now a double, and here's Segui. Sandberg robbed him of a hit back in the second. He walked and scored in the four-run fourth inning.
The Mets were looking at JT Snow. That was supposed to be the deal. Anthony Young for JT Snow. And eventually that deal fell through. And surprisingly, when I talked to some of the guys associated with the Mets, They couldn't believe that J.T. Snow didn't stick with the Angels. They sent him down to the minor leagues. But when that deal fell through, the Vizcaino deal came along, and Anthony Young is now a Cub. And by the way, threw four very strong innings yesterday in Minnesota.
Oh, did he ever.
But I don't have to tell you, because you were there in person.
Indeedy, calling it on the radio side. I still can't figure out why we didn't televise that game. You should have been working. There's a breaking ball down low, 2-1. But then again, there are many days through the course of a regular season where you should be working when actually you're not.
Not many anymore. They have cut those down to a scant few.
No.
Giving Arnie and I a chance, of course, to go to the library.
I like that idea. 2-1, and there's a sharp grounder. Dunston going to come to third, and they will get the runner there. But McReynolds will score from third, making it New York 7 and the Cubs 5. Gives Segui the RBI on the fielder's choice ground ball.
This ball hit very hard, and a good heads-up play by Sean Dunston. And rule of thumb for a base runner, if the ball is hit to your right, there's no reason at all to go. Now watch it again. The run's going to score, no doubt about that. And I don't know what in the world Jeff Kent was thinking about, but he should have stayed at second base, forced Dunston to make the long throw to first, in which case he still had a man in scoring position. So we've seen a couple of suspect base running plays today. But the Cubs concede the run and fall two down.
Runner at first, two men out. We're in the top of the fifth inning. Mets in front, 7-5, and here's Jeremy Burnett. He is flying to left, doubled down the right field line, and scored in the four-run New York fourth inning. It's opening day 94. Huge crowd, and weather could not have been more cooperative. Last few opening days, Tony, we've had here at Wrigley Field have not been pleasant.
Well, stick around for tomorrow, Tommy boy, and you will see it be too pleasant.
Rain on the parade, at least for today.
But today it's beautiful. What a nice day.
See what I mean? A guy like you, and I figured by this time this year you would have come around a little bit.
I'm a ball of sunshine today. This is a beautiful day.
Yeah, I know, but you're already looking ahead of tomorrow and the disastrous conditions they are forecasting. 2-0 the count.
Just wear that pilot's hat that you have for the rain, the one with the flaps over each ear that I see you wear occasionally.
Right.
That's a good look on you. A lot of guys can't wear that.
No, they can't. And not many guys want to. 3-0 on Burnett's.
You got to be careful here, because Burnett's might just get the go-ahead. He is one strong young man.
And he takes ball four. Ilsley's second walk in the inning. 2-1 with two men out, and here comes Ryan Thompson. And that'll warrant a visit by pitching coach Mo Drabowski.
And Dallas Green looking on. Dallas has his work cut out for him. He's taken an organization that really has fallen on hard times. They lost 103 games last year. Dallas took it over in the middle of the season. Felt that he wasn't going to put up with a lack of hustle. Along with Joe McElvain, they cleaned house, Tommy. 13 new faces on this New York Mets ball club.
Ryan Thompson looks at a strike with two on and two men out. And I think they've done a good job. I mean, they'll be the first to tell you they have a long way to go. But when you walk in that New York clubhouse right now, as opposed to early one season ago, you just don't have the tension or the, I'm not sure exactly what the word is, but there's a lot of youth on this ball club, and they genuinely seem excited about playing.
Well, it came out of New York that I think either Dallas Green or Joe McElvain said they're probably going to lose $20 million this year and have a tough season.
Ball knocked down by Bouchel, but a good play there. It prevented the man from scoring from second base. It'll go as an infield hit. But put a star next to that play if Blaze Ilsley can retire Dwight Gooden.
Steve Bouchel had the best fielding record of any third baseman in the National League last year. And odds are he will do it again. He's got exceptional hands, and he saves a run, knocks his ball down. There's nothing he can do with it. But he makes sure, as Bill Hahn motions fair all the way, that the inning continues, and you can't take Dwight Gooden for granted. He is one fine hitter.
Bases loaded for the doctor, and he looks at ball one down and away. Gooden laid down a perfect bunt, leading to a run in the fourth inning. And he can really swing the bat. Segui at third, Burnett's at second, Thompson at first, and now it's 2-0 on Gooden. And this is not the kind of guy, Stoney, you just brought it up. You fall behind to Doc Gooden, it's not like falling behind 2-0 to just your average hitting pitcher.
Oh, especially when you don't have that overpowering fastball, and that's something Blaze Ilsley has to live on his control. And today, I think he's got to be a little nervous out there.
Gooden took a big hack there and fouled it off.
You know, you figure, Tom, he spent so long getting to the major leagues, it looked like he was going to be a star when he came up, had the arm injury with Houston, battled his way back, had a fine year last year in the Cubs organization. Here he is in the major leagues. It's got to be an emotional appearance for him.
And there's a base hit into right field for Gooden. Segui scores. Now they wave around Burnett's. Here's a throw way offline. And Doc Gooden, with a bases loaded, two-run single, has added to this New York lead. It now goes to 9-5 in favor of the Mets.
Take another look at a fastball up when you fall behind. And Tommy was talking about even falling behind to a pitcher. In this case, Doc Gooden is not your typical hitting pitcher. This throw is well off the mark, and Burnett scores under the tag. The Mets have come back after the Cubs came back in the bottom half of their inning, and there's Sean Boskey getting loose.
Runners on the corners, and the batter now, Jose Vizcaino, and Boskey getting ready in a hurry. Vizcaino, 1-for-1, hit a solo home run in the third. He walked in the first, had a sac fly RBI in the fourth. And he'll turn around to bat right-handed and swings and misses.
There was some talk of Brett Saberhagen being traded, but after the addition of Jose Vizcaino, both Joe McElvain and Dallas Green thought their team started to look a little more competitive. And now they figure that they're probably going to keep around Saberhagen, and they like their 1-2-3 of Gooden, Saberhagen, and Pete Smith.
And if you're wondering why Saberhagen is not pitching in this series, he is still serving a 5-game suspension handed down a year ago. But the Cubs will get a look at him. They're holding him back to the home opener a week from today when the Cubs visit Shea Stadium in New York. And that's the inning. But a big inning against Ilsley. New York coming up with 3 runs, 3 hits. 2 men left. Middle of the fifth in Chicago. Cubs are down by 4.
Running a business here comes with ups and downs. The downs make you tougher. The ups keep you pushing. At Wintrust, we know what that's like because we started here too and have found a way forward. From us to you, keep going. We've got your back.
Daddy, what's that big moving house thing?
It's a motorhome, Junior. Modern invention.
Modern invention? We carried our homes with us since, like, forever.
Yeah, but humans have Geico to protect them. Something goes wrong, they're covered. What do we have?
What could go wrong? Ooh, a feather.
A feather? Duck, Junior!
That's no duck, Daddy. That's a vulture!
Geico for RVs. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Gripping excitement of the Cubs' run for the ring as we bring you each game leading up to the 2016 World Series victory. Beginning this Wednesday, Marquee Sports Network will replay a game nightly from the entire 2016 postseason run. Don't miss any game from this special Cubs Classic Series. Cubs Classics, 2016 Run for the Ring, premieres this Wednesday at 7 on Marquee Sports Network. Marquee Sports Network presents Cubs Classics, Mark Grace Opening Day. Relive the action of this 1996 season opener against San Diego.
Cubs win! Cubs win! Cubs win! Holy cow! Mark Grace came through!
With memories and analysis from the experts, Cubs Classics, Mark Grace Opening Day, today at 12 on Marquee Sports Network.
The census, a special time when we count every person in each home in every neighborhood.
Do kids count?
Of course. Counting everyone in your home helps support your neighborhood by funding things like schools, hospitals, and buses. Complete the census by calling or going online, or return your form by mail.
It's easy, secure, and most important, it's totally private.
Make your family count!
This year, make sure every child counts. Visit 2020census.gov.
Hey, welcome back to Cubs Classics. I'm Cole Wright. So, Tuffy Rhodes had homered in his first two at-bats against Dwight Gooden. No player in Major League Baseball history had went deep in their first three plate appearances on opening day. So as Rhodes stepped into the box to lead off the fifth frame, he had a chance to make history at Wrigley Field.
Well, here's been the man of the day for the Cubs, Tuffy Rhodes. Two at-bats, two home runs to left center field, and that time, Doc Gooden comes high and tight.
Well, you pretty much had to expect that. He hit a curveball and a fastball, and Doc is running out of pitches and places to throw Tuffy. So he figured one up and in might be just what the doctor ordered.
And there's a drive. Way back. Oh, my goodness. Rhodes, three home runs. Can you believe it? Three home runs against Dwight Gooden in this his opening day start.
I had the best seat in the house to watch that. I was also the next one to go into the batter's box against a pitcher that wasn't too happy. I didn't know if I was going to get a little chin music or get one in my back to say, hey, guys, don't be hitting the ball out of the ballpark against me as Dwight Gooden. But that did not happen. That was quite an opening day.
And there's a curtain call.
And he deserves a curtain call and a little salam from his teammates. And not a cheap one in the bunch, Tommy. He's hit all three of those right on the button and all three of those to left center field. Well, finally we get a smile out of Tuffy Rhodes. It took a hat trick to do it, but he did it.
And now Rhodes finally, Stoney mentioned, cracking that smile. I mean, what a day. He said he felt a little pressure coming in and taking over as a center fielder, leadoff man. And he's facing a future Hall of Famer, and he has three home runs.
Well, I don't know how long this leadoff man stuff is going to go, but you don't want your leadoff hitter to hit three solo shots as we take another look. After the knockdown pitch, Gooden gets a fastball low and away. So he got a curveball out over the plate. He got a fastball up and away. Now a fastball low and away. And the same result on all three. Three solo home runs. And it's a 9-6 game as this has turned into a wild one at Wrigley Field. Well, folks, we didn't promise you great pitching this year. We promised you a lot of excitement. And that's what's going to happen with this team.
I mean, you know, the thing you got to remember about Carl Rhodes, up until last year when he combined with three different teams to hit a grand total of 33 home runs. Here's a guy who had never hit more than four home runs in an entire minor league season.
Well, Tommy, we did the same thing in the offseason. Tuffy and I really bulked up on the weights, and that's why he hit home runs last year. That's why my golf swing was a little bit better, and that's why my back blew out.
Do me a favor. Don't compare your physical stature right now, being rather broken down, with the way this guy's. He's putting on the wrong hat. Somebody must have thrown his hat.
Hey, he's just excited. He's going to put on any hat.
Well, the kid who comes from the city where baseball professionally started, Cincinnati, Ohio, looks like he invented the game here today.
Billy Williams is talking to him. Billy said, that's the way I used to do it, Tuffy, back when it was tough to hit. Not and like today with the lively ball.
Right. Carl Tuffy Rhodes.
Well, the one thing you really hate to see is what's going on right now is a disruption of this game. The Cubs look like they're going to come back in this one. And although you don't mind Dwight standing on the mound a little bit longer than he should, I'd like to see him get cleaned up and get this game underway.
And unfortunately, many of the fans are still throwing either hats or some kind of debris out on the field. And yes, the number of home runs for Tuffy Rhodes today. Don't throw that.
Well, you take a look at the man of the hour as far as the Cubs are concerned, and if you're trying to break in as a leadoff hitter, I couldn't think of a better way to break in than what Tuffy Rhodes has done here today. He's going to leave an indelible impression on not only one Doc Gooden, but the entire National League when they read about what he did this afternoon.
Well, they're finally getting a lot of it cleaned up out here, and it'll still be a few minutes. The last Cub. Well, let's see if we can beat Sharon Panazzo to the punch here.
You'll find the last Cub to hit three home runs, but will you be able to find the last Cub to hit three home runs on opening day?
Oh, well, they don't give us that information. A three-homer game was Andre Dawson. You have to go all the way back to 1987 when he did it against Philadelphia on August the 1st. That, of course, the year Andre Dawson won the National League's Most Valuable Player Award. So just 87 for three home runs in a game. And as Stoney mentioned, forget about opening day. I don't know where you find that.
I don't know if there's another guy that's hit three home runs off Dwight Gooden in his entire career. And that spans well, going on the 11th year, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
Dwight Gooden, this is his 11th year in the major leagues. And I got to believe you can look long and hard and not find another game where he gave up three to the same man.
Oh, I agree with you. This guy's only 154 wins, 81 losses in his career, and an ERA of just over three. All right. It is a 9-6 ball game. And we're only in the bottom of the fifth. Sandberg, one of two. And he's down a ball and two strikes to Dwight Gooden.
Arnie Harris going out on the line, making one of his fearless predictions here in the fifth inning, saying that nine runs will not win this game.
Yeah. Well, Arnie really goes out on a limb on a regular basis. Sandberg drives one to right center. This ball will split the gap and go cut off by Burnett. And here comes the throw. He has a good arm, but Sandberg able to get in there with a double.
Well, Mike Morgan had some problems today, and Dwight Gooden is starting to take his lumps. He gets the fastball out over the plate. This is a pretty good play by Jeremy Burnett as he cuts this ball off, but he gets entangled with Thompson. And Sandberg, a good heads-up base runner, sees this in front of him, realizing that Burnett has got to extricate himself from Thompson before he can get the throw off. And you're right about one thing, Tommy. Burnett has one of the better arms in right field. But no chance to get Sandberg there, as still nobody out, and Grace has got to pull the ball here.
Grace does pull it. Down on one knee, Segui. He'll go to the bag himself, but Sandberg, now with only one out, advances down to third base. Good job by Grace.
Now the bullpen up and working for the New York Mets. And we'll take a look. David Telgater.
Saw him a few times last season, brought up near the end of the year.
He was 6-2 with the Mets last year, but a high ERA of 4.76. So he did pitch at the right time.
On the ground, it'll bring in another run. Kent will throw out Derek May. And that makes it a 9-7 ball game. So the Cubs have gotten two of them back.
Derek May with a couple of runs batted in today, and Dallas Green electing to keep the infield back. Now, Dallas Green knows this ballpark as well as anybody, and he figures in the fifth inning, there's no reason to allow the Cubs to have any bigger inning than they're going to have, so he concedes the run for the out and knows that it's still relatively early in this game, just about halfway through.
Very moderate temperatures here at Wrigley Field today, a little better than 50 degrees. Oh, but the scoreboard is being lit up by both ball clubs here today. It is 9-7, bottom of the fifth.
Kind of surprised, Tom, that Dwight Gooden has been able to throw his fastball by Sosa. Now, he froze him with a curveball once, but about three or four times, he's just thrown the fastball right by him.
And he does right there again, and I mean right down the middle of the plate.
That's kind of surprising, because last year when Sammy had it tuned up, there weren't too many people that could get that fastball by him.
Well, who's ahead right now? The hitters, the pitchers with a full spring training? The hitters today, I mean, with the winds blowing out, that certainly helped.
Normally early in the season, you will see the pitchers a little more dominating. But, of course, today you could throw that out the window.
Sosa will be retired for the third time. He bounces back to Gooden. Two runs in the inning, couple of base hits. At the end of five, the teams have combined for 16 runs. New York in front by two.
Is it riskier to build your way to growth or buy your way? We have ideas. Find them at wehaveideas.firstmidwest.com. First Midwest Bank. How will the tight labor market affect your bottom line? We have ideas. Find them at wehaveideas.firstmidwest.com. First Midwest Bank.
This is the Frells family's land. When the first snow fell, the kids went sledding right there. This used to be a shed. Now, it's where they get breakfast. This is more than just land. It's home. The Frells family runs with us on a John Deere 1 Series tractor. This land isn't the only thing that should live on for generations. Nothing runs like a deer. Search John Deere 1 Series for more. Get a 1 Series tractor starting at $99 per month.
Are you in a job you can't stand and are working too many hours for too little money? Do you want a rewarding career with great growth potential? By attending My Computer Career, in as little as 4 months, you could be starting your new career in the growing IT field. Classes meet on campus or live online just twice a week. Go to mycomputercareer.edu and fill out the free career evaluation right now. You don't need to be a math or computer whiz at mycomputercareer.edu, and no experience necessary at mycomputercareer.edu.
MS does suck.
MS mucks with your central nervous system. Almost everything about your body, your muscles, your organs, your ability to speak, your ability to understand, your ability to move.
MS took everything from me. Everything I thought was important, everything I valued.
I used to jump on a trampoline and swim with the kids.
MS has affected me being a mom because I'm sorry.
Despite MS, I will keep riding my bike.
I will continue to be the strongest mom that I possibly can.
I will still dance with my husband.
I will continue to live the life that my daughter expects me to live.
Multiple sclerosis may be a part of who you are, but it doesn't define you.
I will never stop. I will never quit.
I'm going to keep being me.
Stone back at Wrigley Field, Chicago, opening day 1994. Gorgeous afternoon. And all the studies suggest that fans love seeing runs scored. And already 16 of them here today.
You know, Tom, it's funny. I kind of get a little impatient with people that talk about the beauty of the game of both football and basketball and how baseball is losing interest to a lot of fans against those two sports. Now, this is a sport that doesn't do anything to change the scoring of the game itself. In football,